Yeah, no, and I think that there's, particularly with the data that companies already have, which is really where our primary focus is, that's something where, again, if you think about your email data, what we're pulling out of that is not content or even your name or email addresses. It's really a team and higher levels, how much different teams talk to each other. When it comes to sensor data, like some of the things that our badges have done, in research contexts, it's really around large-scale communication patterns, hotspots in the office, those sort of things, so that at a macro level, companies can really drive, how big should our headquarters be, what sort of amenities should we have, and that sort of thing. And that's what we really focus on.
So Ben, your examples are really interesting. You've helped a company doing deals figure out which teams need to be close together. You've helped banks be more productive. Are there any broad takeaways that you've learned about the workplace today, especially a lot of these open workplaces, for example? Just kind of a rule of thumb or two that you've learned from all of these experiments.
Yeah, and I think you had maybe Ethan Bernstein on your program yesterday as well, who actually collaborate a lot. And he used our technology actually for some of the results I think he discussed. But I think it is really interesting. There's whether it's looking at open offices, whether it's people working from home a certain amount of time, those things, none of these things are universally good or universally bad, right? It really depends on the context. And I think that companies are too used to making these incredibly large capital investments in their workplace without actually understanding how that changes how people work. And if we only care about cost, what we should just do is have everyone work from home, right? I mean, that's the cheapest. But if we believe there's something about the physical environment that improves how people collaborate, and there is, and there's a huge amount of data we have that, for example, proximity between people dramatically drives not just how we interact face to face, but even how much we chat, how much we have meetings with each other. And those decisions are typically made very haphazardly. And so rather than making one decision and then sticking with it for years, really rapidly iterating and using data to drive those decisions is really how you're going to get much higher levels of performance.